Hi everyone, my name is Eric and I'm an engineer at Microsoft working on Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync. Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync is a service that will help accomplish your hybrid identity goal of synchronizing your users, groups, and contacts from your local Active Directories to Azure Active Directory. We support synchronizing from disconnected forests and use lightweight agents to keep installation and maintenance easy and simple. Today, I'll be showing you a couple of things. How to create your first Cloud Sync configuration, cover some features that may be useful to you, and give you some troubleshooting tips and guidance to help you along the way. Now, let's jump into a demo and see how it's done.
Starting at the Azure homepage, let's show you where in the Azure portal you can configure your first Azure AD Cloud Sync configuration. You can click on this Azure Active Directory button on the homepage, or if it's not here, you can use the search bar and search for it. Scroll down to Azure AD Connect, and you'll see a link here that says Manage Azure AD Cloud Sync. Let's start by creating your first configuration. Hopefully, you've already installed an agent onto the machine with line of sight to your domain controller. If not, you can click this Download Agent button to get the installer. Let's first click on the New Configuration button to create your first configuration. If this button is disabled, check that your agent installation was successful and is running without issues on your machine. From this screen, you can choose which Active Directory you'd like to sync from. Configurations are currently one-to-one with domains, so you only see domains listed that do not already have a configuration associated with them. If you don't see your domain, make sure you don't already have a configuration created with that domain mapped. You can see NAPS domains in your configuration list here. You can also check this box to enable password hash sync on a per domain basis. This will sync password hashes of your selected users to Azure AD. You can turn this off later at any time. Now let's go ahead and create this configuration. After creating configuration, you'll be brought to this screen to edit any settings. The first section is scope, where you'll define your set of users to provision. First, you'll see the domain that you're targeting. Next, you can edit scoping filters. Here, you can define what security groups or organizational units you'd like to provision. We recommend using organizational units, as there are limitations on large and/or nested security groups. For other known limitations, visit aka.ms/cloudsync/known-limitations. To add a security group or organizational unit, find the distinguished name of your object in your Active Directory and add it here. You can add as many as you'd like. Our next section is Manage Attributes. First, you can enable or disable syncing password hashes. This is the same setting as the one we saw earlier in the creation process. If this box is checked, password hashes are synced roughly once every 2 minutes. Next, we can click on the Edit Mappings link. Attribute mapping helps transform attribute values from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory. This helps in meeting your standardization requirements for your Azure AD tenant. Here, you'll see a long list of attributes for your various objects in Azure Active Directory. Here at the top, you can see the object types that are being provisioned. By default in Cloud Sync, users, groups, and contacts are included. Within each of the tabs, a list of attributes that belong to the selected object are shown under target attribute, followed by the source attribute, which is how that information is sourced from your Active Directory. If you need help creating these complex expressions for an expression mapping type, try out our expression builder. You can select various functions, select attributes to use, and test your expression using custom values. Now let's head back to the main configuration page. In our next section, we have the validation section, where you can enter the distinguished name of a user and test out your configuration to make sure you've set it up as you like. We also have a settings section. You can enter your email to be alerted of any provisioning errors or issues. You can also set a threshold to stop any cycles or updates that may mass delete users. For example, you can accidentally remove a large organizational unit from the scope user section, which will in turn remove those users from Azure Active Directory. To prevent large outages of services to many users, you can enable and disable this threshold. The default is 500 users, but we recommend setting this to a number that is proportional to the number of users in your Azure Active Directory. Finally, you can enable your configuration if the settings are to your liking. Objects are provisioned and updated roughly every 10 minutes. After enabling, your first provisioning cycle may complete in as quickly as 15 minutes, but increases based on the users provisioned and complexity of your organizational structure. You can check for the status under the status page for your configuration for more information. Thanks for listening, and make sure to check out the documentation links below to learn more about Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync.